A Cretan taverna in Athens. Manolis, the son of the owner, has, you might think, been dancing on bottles for most of his 18 years. When he's not dancing, he's playing the Cretan lira. Meanwhile, his dad looks after the food, το φαγητό, and the wine, το κρασί.
Πείτε ρατσί, κρασί. Κρασί. Έχουμε καλό κρασί. Σήμα βαρελίσιο.
Κόκκινο.
Κόκκινο.
That's to say, when he's not playing the lira instead. Eating out Greek style is a very informal business, often a family business. As a visitor to Greece, you're more likely to be invited to a meal in a restaurant than in a home. The taverna is mainly a place where people go for a night out. The food is incidental, you might say. Appetizers, called mezedes or mezedakia, keep people going. Age is no barrier. Whole families join in. In this program, I'll be showing you, and of course Chris Searle, how to order a meal in Greek. You'll also see how to make a pita, village style, and find out how two very Greek drinks, ouzo and retsina, are produced. But first we join Chris in Andros, where he's bought a komboloi, to take the worry out of learning Greek, I suppose.
Ένα κομπολόι, παρακαλώ. Ένα καφέ. Ένα μέτριο. Μια μπύρα. Γεια σου. Γεια σας.
Ευχαριστώ.
Ευχαριστώ. That's right. Good morning.
Good morning, Chris.
Good morning to you.
Καλημέρα.
That's good morning.
Mm-hmm.
Καλημέρα.
And in the evening you could say καλησπέρα.
Καλησπέρα. That's for after lunch or mm-hmm. after
the evening.
Tea. In the evening, right.
And at night you could say καληνύχτα, but when you part only.
Right. Καληνύχτα.
Καληνύχτα.
That's good night.
That's good night.
Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, and something else?
What?
Addio.
Addio.
It's another way to say goodbye.
Like the Italian.
Mm-hmm.
Addio. Right, so it's calimera.
Calispera.
Calispera. Calinichta, it's like German.
Mm-hmm.
And addio.
And addio.
Thank you. Give me an appetite. Would you like some lunch?
Ah, yes, please.
Okay. Paracalo. Ah, hello, the menu.
Ένα κατάλογο, παρακαλώ.
Ευχαριστώ.
Yeah.
Have a look. Ground meat. Eggplants shoes is rather nice. Although that's probably quite serious, isn't it? Veal in clay bowl, I like. Pork barbecued. Chicken frozen.
Frozen.
Well, at least that's honest. Oh, great. No, look. Whiskey Thatcher's.
Oh, that's nice, yeah.
That's brilliant. No. I suppose this really ought to be more a matter of recognizing the Greek alphabet than trying to spell out some words. Souvlakia, I know.
Mm-hmm.
And.
Keftedes,
I know. And moussaka, I know.
No, it's moussaka.
Moussaka.
Okay.
All right. Anyway, we really ought to order something. Well, I'm going to have moussaka.
Okay, and I'm going to have. Keftedes, παρακαλώ.
Very good.
Do you know how to order?
No. What do I say? I mean, I could just say moussaka at the moment. What should I say?
There are two ways.
Yes.
Okay? Just
can say, mia salata paracalo, ena moussaka paracalo, or keftedes paracalo. Or you can say, mipos echete salata, mipos echete moussaka, mipos echete psaria. Mipos echete.
Mipos echete.
Maybe you have.
Oh, I see. Maybe you have. Mm-hmm. Right. Mipos.
Echete.
Echete. It's an awful mouthful before you get to the food, isn't it? Mipos echete. Mipos echete. Perhaps you have. Mm-hmm. All right. Shall I give it a try? Mm,
do.
Paracalo. Paracalo.
Mipos echete moussaka.
Oi.
That means no, does it?
No.
No. Right. Mipos echete keftedes.
Oh.
Yeah. What else would you like? What about some souvlakia? Mipos echete souvlakia?
What?
Psaria?
I know. Why don't we ask him what he has got?
Okay. Τι έχετε?
Αν θέλετε, ελάτε μέσα στην κουζίνα να δείτε μόνοι σας.
Why don't we go in the kitchen and see?
Oh, yes.
Ένα μουσακά, παρακαλώ. Μία σαλάτα, παρακαλώ. To order an item in a Greek restaurant, you can just name it. Or if you're not sure they have it, ask. Μήπως έχετε σουβλάκι, kebabs. Μήπως έχετε κεφτέδες, that's meatballs. By the way, this is a Greek question mark, and you'll have noticed that some of the small letters in Greek are slightly different from the capitals. There's more about that in the Greek Language and People book. Now, if you simply want to know what is on the menu in a Greek restaurant, say, τι έχετε, what have you got? Τι έχετε? And if, like Chris, you're invited into the kitchen, you'll need to identify the more unusual dishes. Τι είναι αυτό? What's that? Τι είναι αυτό?
Είναι αυτό.
Γίγαντες.
Γίγαντες. Obviously beans. That's,
yes, jam beans.
Right. What, τι είναι αυτό?
Παστίτσιο.
Παστίτσιο.
It's macaroni pie.
Mm. Right. What about the vegetables? Yeah. Τι είναι αυτό?
Yes.
Πιπεριές γέμισε.
That's stuffed peppers with rice and minced meat.
Tomatoes, I can see that. What's that lovely looking thing with courgettes and things?
Briand. It's a mixture of vegetables, potatoes, courgette, and onions, and tomato sauce.
This looks delicious, this red. Tiene afto.
Cortinisto.
It's veal with tomato sauce.
Right.
In the casserole.
Right. And there's some beautiful looking fish there.
Oh, yeah.
Right. Well, what would you like to eat?
Stuffed tomatoes for me in tomatoes in this.
And I'm going to have some stuffed green peppers, and I've forgotten what they are.
Piperiés gemistés.
Piperiés gemistés.
Piperiés.
Piperiés
gemistés.
Mars.
Good. Now, that's it.
For salad?
For salad. Mia salata.
Mia salata.
Χωριάτικη.
Χωριάτικη.
Peasant.
Right. You're going to have one as well?
Me as
right.
Well.
Two.
Και για μένα.
Δύο σαλάτες χωριάτικες.
What's that?
What are you going to drink?
No, I can do this. Ένα μπουκάλι ρετσίνα and water. Νερό.
Μάλιστα.
Ένα μπουκάλι ρετσίνα και νερό, παρακαλώ. Right.
And now, Sunday lunchtime in the Pelion region, eastern Greece. Ταβέρνα ψισταριά ο Στάθης.
Γεια σας.
Γεια σας.
Γεια σας.
Τι θα σας δώσουμε?
Τι έχει
σπεντζοφάι. Η μοσχάρι ψητό. Σουζουκάκι, αλλά σμυρνέα. Μπριζόλα, μοσχαρή κρίσα. Μπριζόλα, χοιρινή. Παϊδάκι. Αυτά. Να σας βάλω ένα μοσχαράκι ψητό. Με πατατά για τη γανιτά. Να σας βάλω μια σουζουκάκια. Να σας πεις μια μπριζόλα.
Και μια
κόκα-κόλα. Και μια κόκα.
Εγώ θέλω να μου φέρετε σπεντζοφάι.
Ένα σπεντζοφάι.
Μια φασουλάδα.
Φασουλάδα τέλος.
Τα παπά, τι μας έχεις κάνει τώρα.
Τι να σας κάνω
εγώ. Εγώ μόνο για τη φασουλάδα και μόνο ήρθα εδώ. Τι θα γίνει τώρα,
θα σας κρατήσουμε αύριο. Να σας δώσουμε αύριο.
Ένα ψητό με πατάτες.
Ένα ψητό με πατάτες. Πάει.
Θα
πιείτε τίποτα.
Κρασί.
Κρασάκι.
Όχι, στην ανοίγηνο.
Η
σόδα της κυρίας. Πατατάκια. Και άλλα πατατάκια. Το σπεντζοφάι.
Getting the bill, το λογαριασμό, can require a little patience in Greece.
Το λογαριασμό παρακαλώ. Πιο δυνατά.
Καρσόν,
το λογαριασμό.
3 σουτζουκάκια, 2 κοκακόλες, 1 σπεντζοφάι, 2 πατάτες, 3 οι πατάτες γίνανε, 1 μπύρα, 1 φέτα, 1 σαλάτα, 1 γίδα και 1 χωριάτικη. 15, 20...
Καβαλιέρο,
24, 29, 37, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 17, 1775. Ορίστε.
Στην υγεία σας.
Στην υγεία.
I hope you like red scene, all right. I mean, I just asked for it straight out, right?
I love it.
Well, it seems it tastes of resin. I've always wondered why.
You see, in older times, when casks and bottles had not been invented yet, Greeks used to keep the wines in goat skins. And in order to preserve them, they just poured a bit of resin from pitch pine on top of it.
What, to seal the...
To seal the wine.
Yes.
So the wine tasted of resin. And even after the casks and bottles had been invented, they still wanted their wine to taste of resin. That's why.
It's a very interesting and distinctive taste, and it's part of the flavor of Greece. But I know it's not to everybody's taste, and I guess there must be some Greek people as well as English people who like their wine without the resin. Mm-hmm. If I wanted to have that, what would I ask for?
Krasi.
Meaning wine.
Wine.
Yeah.
Red, kokino.
Kokino.
White, aspro.
Kokino, aspro. Kokino is red, aspro is white. Krasi is wine.
Yes.
Right. Driving through Greece, it's hard to miss all the vineyards. There's obviously a terrific amount of wine grown here. What do I ask for if I want to get the wine of the region?
Doppio krasi.
Doppio?
Doppio is local.
Doppio krasi.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Here's to Greek wine.
Yes.
The traditional mainstays of the Greek diet have always been bread, ψωμί, olives, ελιές, and of course wine, κρασί. The Nausa region of Macedonia, northern Greece, is justly famous for its red wine. Red wine is not what Greece is best known for. Yanis Boutaris, the owner, explains.
Well, we produce about 6 million bottles a year. Half of it is red quality wines, and the other half of it is red and white table wines. Now, in this half, the second half, we have about 400,000 to 500,000 bottles of Retsina, which is a very popular Greek wine, national wine. Now, if you drink Retsina as an ordinary wine, then you won't like it. If you expect from a Retsina the same atmosphere, the same taste as of a white wine, then you won't like it. But if you drink it in a way a Greek drinks it, then you love it.
The other archetypal Greek drink is, of course, ouzo.
Ouzo used to be done by distilling the residues from the winemaking procedure. Nowadays, factories are obliged to buy alcohol from the spirit alcohol factories and distill this alcohol together with aniseed and make ouzo.
No Greek meal is complete without bread. The bakery, or fournos, has always been at the center of the Greek village, and not just for the baking of bread. Villagers traditionally bring their pies or even the Sunday joint to the baker's oven in a special tray called tapsi.
Stay!
The tapsi is also used to bake pitas, the Greek pies, said, like much of Greek food, to be of Turkish origin. In Metsovo, northern Greece, the pitas are rather special. Like pizzas, are more and more synonymous in Greece with fast food, especially in Athens. Tiropita, cheese pie, bougatza, sweet pie, spanakopita, spinach pie.
Thank you.
Traditional Greek fast food includes, of course, souvlaki, or doner kebab. Less traditional, perhaps, frankfurters and hamburgers. Athenians are more likely these days to eat lunch standing up. Even the Greek way of life has to adapt to Western commercial pressures. But there's one item a Greek table will always contain, and without which, it has even been said, there could not have been a Greek classical civilization: the olive. October the 26th, Agios Dimitrios, St. Demetrius Day, is traditionally the date when new wines are tasted and the new olive harvest begun. On the Ionian island of Corfu, the nets are simply laid around the olive trees and the olives allowed to fall throughout the winter. In the Mani region of the Peloponnese, trees are pruned and the olives frequently clawed or beaten from the trees and branches. Some of this harvest will be used in salads and cooking. Most of it will be pressed and processed into olive oil. Olive growing has always been a desperately hard living for Greeks, now more than ever. Not by olives alone can the Greek village survive, though it's hard to imagine a Greek landscape without them. Back in the restaurant in Andros, our lunch finally arrived.
Tomatoes?
Tomatoes.
Here you go.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Ευχαριστώ.
Τίποτα.
What did you say?
Ευχαριστούμε.
What's that?
We thank you.
Oh, we thank you?
Mm-hmm.
Not ευχαριστώ.
Ευχαριστώ, I thank you.
Right.
Καλή όρεξη.
What's that?
Good appetite.
Καλή
όρεξη.
Καλή όρεξη.
Το παίρνεις με το χώρα του σε ελεύθερη σύγχρονη.